This story was told by my father-in-law, the chassid of the Meshad Gaisinski Zichlein Livrocho, and it happened at the end of 1959. Which means it was before Yom Kippur of Tovshin Chof. Yom Kippur was on a Monday. Sunday night was Kol Nidrei. And this was Shabbesenacht, 10 o'clock at night. Two young men come to his house without an appointment. And they say, "Rabbi, we have bad news." Two brothers. One was Louis, one was Mordechai. And my father-in-law was Arov, in a shul in East New York. It's a neighborhood, unfortunately, now there're no longer Jews there, but at that time there were a lot of Jews in East New York, and he was alone in one of the shuls, and they would come in from time to time to the shul. Louis became closer, and he put on tefillin every day with time, and he started eating kosher. My father-in-law even brought him to the Rebbe once. Now, they both come. They are both coming, and Louis says to my father-in-law, "We have bad news." Mordechai didn't feel well. He went to the doctor or to doctors, and they made the tests, and they told him that he has a malignant tumor, and the doctors feel that he should do an operation immediately. One doctor says that maybe we can wait a little bit, but most doctors feel that he should do the operation immediately. And they're here to find out and ask for a brocha. And he says to them, it's 10 o'clock at night. He says to them, "If you want this, the one that can help you is only the Rebbe. If you want to see the Rebbe, you can call Rabbi Chodakov. But I don't think that he's going to give you an appointment to see the Rebbe before Yom Kippur. Tomorrow night is Kol Nidrei. But if he says no, then the only thing I can tell you is go to 770. The Rebbe is still in 770, as he generally is, Mitzoy Shabbos. And when the Rebbe leaves his room to go to the house, then go over to the Rebbe and talk to him." They called Rabbi Chodakov. Rabbi Chodakov said it's impossible to have an appointment before Yom Kippur. So now they went to 770 and they're standing outside of the Rebbe's room. The Rebbe goes out of his room. The Rebbe closes the door. The Rebbe is going home. So they approach the Rebbe. And Louis starts telling the Rebbe what it is. The Rebbe goes back to him, opens the door, goes back into his room. The Rebbe invites them into his room. And the Rebbe says to them, "Two times, I was waiting for you." And then the Rebbe says to Mordechai, you don't need an operation. What you need is to put on tefillin every single day, starting from tomorrow morning. I am going to give you a diet to eat." The Rebbe meant what you should eat, what is kosher, and so on. "And in a few weeks, I will make you an appointment. You'll be able to see my doctor, Dr. Zelikson, and you don't need an operation." They went back to see my father-in-law about 1 o'clock in the morning, and now they are so happy. Next day, the Rebbe was giving lekach. Oh, and the Rebbe told him he should start putting on tefillin immediately, starting from tomorrow morning, which is Erev Yom Kippur. In those days, Erev Yom Kippur, the Rebbe would give lekach. My father-in-law is online to receive lekach, and the Rebbe generally would not speak any extra words by lekach. He would say, "Ashono tevo umsuko." When he passed by, the Rebbe asked him, "Did Mordechai put on tefillin today?" He said, "Yes." And he says, "Monitor it, that he should put on tefillin every day." After Yom Tov, Mordechai asked the Rebbe whether he should do another series of x-rays, and the Rebbe said if he wants to, he can. And he did another series of x-rays, and they showed that everything is clean. Plus, he started gaining weight, which in cases like this, we shouldn't know. Gaining weight is a very, very good sign. The doctor said, "Come back in 6 weeks. But when you come back in 6 weeks, you should check into the hospital for one day, and then we will do all the tests, and then we will tell you if we need you to stay in the hospital or you are released." He checked in for one day. The doctor did all the tests, and at the end he said to him, we did all the tests, and we found that everything is clean. You can go home immediately." But the doctor was wondering. He didn't know what happened here, because he remembers the x-rays before and after. So the doctor was wondering. But Mordechai was not wondering. Mordechai knew exactly what happened. Mordechai knew that he went to the Rebbe, and the Rebbe told him that you do not need an operation, and that you should start putting on tefillin every single day, and he did, and he knew exactly what was happening. And as mentioned, I heard the story from my shved, from my father-in-law, the chosid, the Meisha Aron Gaisinski, zichrono livrocho, and it happened at the end of 1959, before Yom Kippur Tov Shin Chof.